A very beautiful morning to you who's just joining us right now on yet another beautiful episode of Abin Today. Another day to wake up while smiling with a laughter on your face. And of course, not forgetting the fact that you need to take a glass of some warm water as well as get on your knees and pray for a beautiful and better day. My name is Derek Ainadash, and of course, it is a Tuesday, 30th of July, 2019. One day to kick July off the lesson. Of course, then you know you have a couple of months left into 2020. Well, it's daily. Antina Fias always joining me up to this, up to the hour of 11. Good morning to you guys.
Good morning. How are you?
Oh, thank you for the confession. But you need to take, you know, some warm water. I see you have coffee there. I think it should double as a substance.
Wagamba an apple, smanya saves vichite. Wagamba an apple 3 times a day. Techiniko formula.
Okay, it's okay.
No, techiniko formula.
Toyomba, it's okay.
Atunaga, aninga gamba, it's okay, it's okay. It's a crime, but it's okay.
my morning is good. I'm coming down with a cold, so pray to the heavens above that y'all don't catch it.
Jesus.
Other than that, it's a beautiful morning. It's cold. There's a certain and of course, if you're still bundled up in bed, it's a beautiful thing. Still, I guess you get waters, and we get to share this morning.
Well, if you're bundled up in bed, you're probably unemployed, or you probably did night duty. If you did night duty, you're safe.
Did night duty pay? If it paid, you're safe.
If you're unemployed.
If you're unemployed, there are two things involved. If someone is paying for your expenses, you're safe. If you have to depend on your unemployment self, there are two things involved.
Which are?
If you're a beggar, you're safe.
You will get.
If you're a believer, there are two things involved.
Mm-hmm.
You will go to Bujingo and put in offer to
And if you slept like pass, Bijirimana also, hey. Shout out to you. Meanwhile, this man is not having good days. So after he had been appointed, you know, to his new position, permanent secretary, yesterday Park, you know, called him and sat down and asked him, "You boss, we allocated 183 billion Ugandan shillings for you to use in domestic areas. But before you start your new duty, we want you to explain why you used only 3.7 billion Ugandan shillings. Where is the rest of the money?"
And his response?
"I used it on water, electricity."
No, but seriously.
And paid some workers who had not been paid yet.
Lol.
Yeah.
But the thing about Bijirimana is someone actually did a meme and it made so much sense. It got me looking back into his track record in all these offices. Pretty much every office he goes into, there is money that was missing at some point. So we want to understand. If it is a track record, because when Park sits, remember when Park sits, they have to pay money for water, drinks. Well, it's a whole process.
I don't know.
Avoid wasting our taxpayers' money.
Chivumbi kagole goya, you know, we against them before you. You have the permanent secretary of judiciary. Aliku forced to leave because of misusing money.
And
the same way, Bijirimana misused the money the other side. So kagamba bidia otebute
gerekeka.
So
who is the fallen Zimani? I don't know if I'm going to do this. I don't know if I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this.
Oh,
so
no.
Is that the guy probably has no fault and this money is being misused by people who sign on the money. Because when it's PS, he's not really the technical accountant.
True, but the PS is supposed to know.
Why is it that sentence that I'm going to do this? I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. The people.
Zabulangari in the previous office. Chibumbi zo zabuzenga yabade permanent secretary. Yazimi siyuzinga.
Ante era mu office yemu.
Neda.
Bijirimana jazemu kati yemu. Pia. Chibumbi aliku first leave. Na ye rija abade.
Na
ye babade bamunyenya. Paki ya muwa sente mparliamenti.
And he bought water.
Na gula.
Paid for electricity.
Oba bakubinanda ya gula peni.
Never know. Remember, I was still waiting. You know how beautiful it is to be a Ugandan. You know it's beautiful when something is as heinous as that, the pens that cost all that money. We made noise about them, drew memes, did everything. But no one actually took the moment out to be like,
Sente wali wengeri chiziita mu bwezi.
Omanyo mtu atasobola kubako na chakola okulima bukolimi.
Katukolime.
Bantikale.
Katukolime
dada. Nenyanyi za fezi chali wali kuentebe ya poti.
Enyanyi za kwa wanga za abuzi.
Enyanyi za kwa wanga
za abuzi.
You better yes. Has got certificate to finally operate. So it's going to be a fantastic journey for
someone
us.
Someone has asked me, why don't you take the Uganda Airlines flight as like Munde Kenjagala Koma?
This is Charlie Mu Africa.
But the Uganda Airlines are made by the same company that make these other planes.
Yes.
Exactly.
Just because this one has like a flag doesn't mean that it's
less or better. True say. But you see the mentality we're going out for here that Ugandans want to sell is because of their car size and how they look like and they're not the best from their fleet.
A plane is a plane, unless you know you're differentiating in terms of classes and whatnot.
Mm. Your bike is not the same as BMX.
I really want to find out what food they're going to serve. That's one of the things I'm so eager to find about.
It's going
I pray it's local food.
It's going to be local food, but it's confusing.
But what local food?
Because if you have 80% of people on the flight as OP or Kel or James, how are you going to give them a shabu? So it has to change depending on the bookings.
It doesn't change because of the bookings. I believe they're going to do like almost every other international flight. What they do is they have vegetarian and then non-vegetarian. Then for the people who don't eat in between,
vegetarian te vili yo.
Muni mu ndia nyama siri ya nyama.
Nterake nyama kusai no ntereko greens.
Nechinyebo.
Aba singa weba tuwebali ya. Bali, but they are both vegetarian.
Kwa full course meal, mutuleke muna mwa, mutuleke.
That's
being Ugandan. Ananga baraba za bali yeyonga goli mukwano yakala koze sako kunyonyeze Uganda bazuwade certificate so
gende tambula.
Eh abagende Mombasa. Nenge byo nabichali awo alo balavazi be ba arresting the over faking kidnap. So apparently police in Kabale district is holding two lovers suspected over fake kidnap. According to Eli Mate, Kigezi Regional Police spokesperson, the suspects are Susan Kachabe, 22 years of age, and Rubadia Kinomwezi, age 25, both residents of Rukabara B cell in Kabale municipality. Now, Mate said Kachabe works with the National Water and Sewage Corporation, Kabale branch, while Kinomwezi is a news anchor at Peak FM, a local radio station based in Kabale district. The two are helping police with investigations where Kachabe is alleged to have been kidnapped from Kabale township by unknown assailants in a black saloon car for a ransom of 4.5 million Ugandan shillings on July 26th at around 8 p.m., said Mate. Mate said that the matter was reported at Ruchika police station on July 27th, 2019 by a relative where Kachabe hails from. Mate also went ahead to say that because they claimed she was kidnapped from Kabale, both districts have worked hand in hand in tracking the phone of Susan, the victim, which she was personally using in negotiating claims she was doing as instructed by kidnappers. The search came to an end on July 28th at around 11 p.m. where police discovered her at her hideout in Rukaraba, Twinomwezi's place, that is the boyfriend. According to him, the two are helping police to establish the truth of the matter, whether she had been truly kidnapped or it was a case of self-kidnap to coin their parents. That's some starter coming
first
in right
of all,
there.
One is 25, the other is 26. Mm. Jesus.
25, 22.
National Water came out, actually tweeted and said, "Dear good people, we have visited the police station and discovered that the suspect in custody is not part of National Water family, but a private plumber in the district. Thank you."
Oh! Bamwega.
Already bamboo food them.
It could be the truth. By the time
because I mean, if you look at it, National Water employee, radio presenter, where did they meet really?
Maybe this lady came for an interview, and Obadia, the presenter. Oh, your badia, okay. So
what do you do?
What do you do?
Let's badia,
know.
Yeah. Na badia ringechintu. Obadia nafuna obuziba amaze waka na mukubira na mgambo wa. Kachabe. Jizonya mbimo ana nanka ni sinki yanje kandi ya badi tobzu.
And we moved forward like that.
Like and then say kwa anje wamba gambe sawa. Nene mbera muzande waba. Nene mbera muzande waba.
By the way, remember what they used to tell us when we were young? Oboro nembwa.
No guy say ganye ka ne wambi. Ne we wamba.
Na yate no vayonga na wito wesa solidarity. Na yate wali akusa solidarity.
Atenga omulimo bakugobye.
Omulimo bakugobye. Atenga eche ugenda kusabing a sentence for just, this is misconduct. Fraudulent.
How do you kidnap yourself?
Hoodwinking.
And you use your phone to communicate.
With the kidnappers.
For ransom. Really?
Like that, it was a
zam.
Oh, it's a beautiful thing to be
afraid. For now, you
take
a kidnapper.
I think I can kill it.
Hello. I'm saying,
I'm saying,
there's a problem of being in a relationship when you're both broke. I keep telling you guys, man, it's not good to be in a relationship.
Better.
Yeah, one has to be better than the other.
Hey, one has to add more.
He's a quiet radio presenter. I don't know if I'm getting a plumber. And then you think.
No, I'm not going to
be a radio presenter.
That's my thing. I'm a quiet radio presenter. I'm getting a plumber. The question you're going to find out is up to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, all these views are.
I'm not a TV presenter. I'm getting a chip. Executive of National Water and Sewage Corporation.
Nechitambula.
Sente diriho. But anyway, let's get into some shout-outs coming in now. Of course, my shout-out is going in all the way here to the legendary lady, Dr. Stella Nyanzi. What has she done this time around? Now, apparently, she's accusing the magistrate of unfairness and has asked the High Court for a retrial. Makerere University researcher Dr. Stella Nyanzi has asked the High Court in Kampala to order for a retrial of her cyber harassment case against President Yoweri Museveni before another judicial officer, saying Buganda Court Road Magistrate Mrs. Gladys Kamasanya, I beg your pardon, has not given her a fair hearing. Dr. Stella Nyanzi, who is now on remand at Luzira Prison, on Monday appeared before Justice Jane Francis Obado seeking to block her judgment scheduled for Wednesday this week and have an entire proceeding of the lower case revised through the team of lawyers led by Mr. Julius Galisonga and Mr. John Esabrie. Dr. Stella Nyanzi condensed that she was not accorded an opportunity of defending herself by presenting witnesses because Buganda Road Court did not dally service and also observe the witness as she had requested.
Yeah, I think that Dr. Stella Nyanzi should be a doctor about herself. And, you know, see
that. Exactly.
Because we all saw the posts, we all saw what she wrote.
We are all
involved. We have screenshots in our phones. Mm. We have.
And we're still shook to the core.
Yes.
I think
she should just be a doctor.
Or not about it.
You know, apologize to the president.
But now this other thing is also confusing me. After, you know, Stella Nyanzi had been remanded to, you know, the prisons for the very first time, she came up to say it's okay. This is the best place for me to be. Let me stay. Let me teach these women what. Katate now, she wants a retrial. Sim tegele. Yako yeyo.
Neda.
You see, there's one thing I'm going to tell people. Yes, being a martyr for a cause is not a bad thing. You know, you set precedent for very many people. But let us be honest. When Stella did what she did, she was of conscious and sane mind. So when the government decides to also act out of conscious and sane mind, let us not begin acting like as though the government has a problem here. This is something very simple. This is a grown-up woman. She's respected in society regardless of how off. Yes, she is.
She's a doctor.
She is.
Okay.
She is. And not just being a doctor. She's a mom.
Okay.
She's among those people who will say something and you'll hear it. I don't think she would lose anything by... She's setting a good example. Just come out, say, you know what? What I did, what I said, it was out. I was coming from this type of place. Don't you take?
For me, the likes of my you know, land friend Galisonga, to go out and represent, you know, such a case is very disturbing for me.
How?
Because I start to look at him in a different light. Somebody has to represent, but you know, you can choose not to. You understand?
Yes, this, but eventually someone else is going to.
Imagine it comes out and, you know, Dr. Stella Nyanzi is exonerated and she has nothing to answer to this case. What precedent that does this set to the future, you know, cases? Does someone have the right to just come and abuse anyone they want online?
Well,
you know,
pretty much
these guys need to think about this as they represent such people.
I do understand, but you see, even murderers and serial killers have
lawyers. Yes.
That's the beauty of being a human being.
It's different for murderers because, you know, there has to be proof beyond reasonable doubt. here the proof that is there.
Is there beyond reasonable doubt?
It was her handle. She didn't deny it. Everyone said it's her. We saw what she wrote.
She acknowledged that it was her.
It was her profile.
So why is he asking for a retrial? That's one thing I'm not understanding.
I think the 4 years, because at first they were saying that she was going to look at about 4 years. Mm. So I think she's asking for a retrial.
So she could reduce the sentence?
Probably she could reduce the sentence. But or, you know, go down guns blazing and say, yes, if you're giving me 20 years to life, it's okay. But I'm going to say what I have to say.
Is she going to get you into the stand? Are they going to say, no, listen, have
all
fun.
Of us.
Have fun.
We are the ones who stole
Uganda is a,
it was her
main entire No, that the entire Uganda is a witness on the side of the government. Mm-hmm. You know, because now it is the people versus, no, it is actually it's Stella Nyanzi, the government versus Stella Nyanzi. So we are part of the government and we're citizens. So we would be witnesses on the government side, I think.
But anyway, you never know. No one should be arrested for insulting me.
That is the law.
Anyway, Stella Nyanzi, you know, Charlie, we don't miss you.
Lol.
Yes,
anyway, I miss her drama though.
Go to Luzia, you'll find enough of it.
Yeah. I bet there's tons of stuff.
This was the start of, you know, drama club in Luzia.
Yeah.
A film company in Luzia.
Exactly.
Wow.
Comedies.
That's where we're going with this, boys.
Yeah. I mean,
you know what? So let me send shout outs to things that matter. Anyway, my shout out is going to none other than General David Sejusa. Now, the very controversial army man is back in the papers this time. What is happening? Now, he is missing on the list of retiring generals again. Now, although General David Sejusa had applied to the UPDF expressing the desire to retire from the army, he is not on the list of those cleared to retire. His name was reportedly removed. This is not the first time Sejusa's name is missing on the list of soldiers retiring. Last year, the UPDF retired 11 generals, which makes the number of generals retired in the last 1 year to 30. According to UPDF spokesperson Richard Karamirehi, it is now part of UPDF to retire officers of all ranks, including the highest ranks. Sejusa says he's already a retired officer after the High Court ruled in 2016 that he was no longer a serving UPDF officer since he had spent years without getting benefits from the army. He says it is of no consequence for him to appear on the list of the retiring soldiers, and UPDF doesn't really need to. Okay, according to him, he's not on the list of retiring soldiers, doesn't need UPDF retirement. On 17 February 2012, David Tinyefuza officially changed his name to David Sejusa. He said Sejusa is a family name that is also reflected on some of his academic documents, but that he had abandoned it around secondary level school. But then he would reclaim as everybody back home refers to him as such. Now, this goes back to the story that was in the dailies yesterday when General Tumukunde was saying, let us retire some of these generals because it's like keeping a Pandora's box. Anytime it's open, it's going to be a truckload of different drama.
And for me, that right there is where the message is. It's like keeping a Pandora's box.
I think
if someone is a Pandora's box and you need to keep them safe,
really safe as
possible. Your... Because I think there's a reason why since 1996, then General David Sejusa has not been allowed to retire. I think there is probably what he knows or some information.
Of course, he definitely knows
or boundaries too much. That you know he would go to if he was let to retire. So I think there's a reason why this guy is not being let to retire, and I think he also knows it, and that is why he's saying
he's not bothered.
I don't really
care
because you know at the end of the day I don't get a salary or whatever from the army. So I think it's a mutual agreement between the army and him, and you know politicians and public.
But what does the army lose by retiring him?
It loses a lot of control. It loses a lot of control because now they have control over him. He's an army officer.
He cannot breach particular.
Exactly.
Contracts.
Yeah. So
anything he does or say
can
be court martial.
Court martial.
Lieutenant General Oguchi does not joke.
Imagine. Stop scaring us. He does not joke here when Charlie Gonza is walking the streets of Kampala.
Charlie Gonza. Tinyefuza.
Is Tinyefuza.
And Sejusa is Tinyefuza.
But I wonder how the kids of, you know,